How to get over brick walls in Overwatch. One particular question that gets sent to me somewhat often is, I've hit a point where no matter what I do, I'm not climbing. I watch videos every day and try to focus on improvement, but I just can't get better. Hello everyone, I hope you're doing fine. My name is Skyline, and this is something I've had to face multiple times in the past. And there's one answer that has worked 100% of the time for me without fail. Take a break. That's funny. Sky just had a bit of a YouTube/Overwatch break. I wonder if the topic of this video has anything to do with that. Yes. Yes, it does. I felt that taking a short hiatus and coming back with a fresh mind would bring my content to the next level and let me evolve the channel while I still had the chance. I mean, we're already at like, what are we, 76,000 subs? Jeez. I still can't believe it. You guys are awesome, especially the people watching this video, because it's been like 2 weeks, right? But if we get much higher to like 100 or 200,000 subs, I would just lose too much by taking a break, and this is kind of my last chance. But anyway, what is the benefit of stepping back to begin with, and how should you do it? Just stepping away for 2 weeks alone will not necessarily help you if you don't do it right. So that's what I'm going to talk about. I'm sure that many of you know how learning works with the human brain. Basically, there are neural pathways, that's what they're called, associated with various actions, and every time you repeat an action in a certain context, that pathway is strengthened. So, for example, if I'm in the practice range and I flick to this bot on the left, I have reinforced that action. So, the next time the scenario comes up where I have to flick that specific distance to the left, my brain will just be a bit more comfortable and consistent in doing it. New players can't help but form bad habits. It's impossible not to do. This isn't just aim either. This manifests in bad crosshair placement, failure to habitually check corners, failing to see new strategies, and having bad positioning, the entire gambit. A lot of these habits aren't too hard to shake off, but especially if you've climbed significantly, like from silver to diamond or something, that's a lot of the players who come to me are people who've climbed significantly. You will have a few silver habits that stuck with you all the way up to diamond that you probably don't even notice, and these will hold you back forever, basically. Now, the way to most easily break out of this is to simply take a break. I spoiled that in the beginning of the video, but a sizable break, at least 2 weeks. This is enough time for all the neural pathways related to Overwatch and FPS games to weaken a bit, so that when you return, you can easily trailblaze new and better habits with the knowledge you have as a diamond player, as opposed to the ones you made back when you were still a silver player. It isn't so simple, however. You need to make sure you do it right, or else all you'll have done is wasted 2 weeks. First of all, you need to fill in the time you'd normally be playing Overwatch with fulfilling activities that you enjoy but aren't really related. For example, you don't want to take a break from Overwatch in order to play Quake. They're too similar. And you'll find your habits from Overwatch will leap over and latch onto Quake, so they won't weaken at all, but actually get even stronger. You can fill it with fishing or whatever, but I'm a gamer, so instead of playing Overwatch and making Overwatch content, I simply played different games. I went back to trading card games, love those. Board games, again, they require very different skills from Overwatch. I'm sure a lot of you noticed also that I was playing PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds. A shooter, technically, yes, but it's basically nothing like Overwatch in terms of strategy, pace, or aim. It let me try out much slower and tactical gameplay. Alright, so you've taken your break and you want to come back. This is the most important part. If you squander the first day, you may have wasted the entire 2 weeks you were on break. You need to come back and you need to think as outside the box as possible. Try to come up with new strats. Stretch your mind. You aren't locked into the rigid mindset you find yourself in after grinding for months, you know, normally. Your brain is free. Make sure you lock in perfect habits now. When you train your aim, make sure you do it right. Check out my aiming guide for that. Make sure your movements are technically correct. I have a movement guide for that. I have a video for all these things at this point. Make sure you have proper crosshair placement and take the right angles. Play super diligently, because if you play as perfectly as possible on your first day back, you will come out of your first few days back a complete monster. And yeah, it only really takes a few days for you to completely reacclimate yourself to the game, so do not squander that time. Now, I recommend that even professional players do this as well. I don't think that a lot of pro players take enough breaks, and I know that some of them watch my videos because they message me about them frequently. The issue that they have, though, and why they can't take breaks, is that pro players, they rarely have the time. There are tournaments frequently enough that you're always grinding for the next one. This is where a coach really comes in handy. The way to break bad habits without having to take a break is to get a high-quality, experienced coach to break you out of your habits for you. That's for another video, though. Good coaches aren't free, and you probably want to do as much as you can yourself before you pay someone else to help you with it. Plus, my videos are free here, so take advantage of that. But yeah, I basically did what I described above, except for video making. I took some time off, watched a lot of great content creators for inspiration in the meantime, and we're back. I'm back to the channel and have a lot of messages in my backlog, frankly, for email. So if you sent me something and I didn't respond, send it again and I'll hopefully see it. I think I might also move my daily series, if you're familiar with that, on my second channel, to this channel as well instead, because it was an experiment and I'm not sure I really liked having the two channels. I'm just going to keep it to one, maybe. So anyways, as always, leave stuff in the comments. I read them all. I love them. Love you guys. Never forget to stay positive. And have a great day. See you soon. See you tomorrow, in fact.